Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2089, narrowing the selection after touching a merge cell. All right, well, if you've watched the podcast, you've probably heard me say that merge cells are evil. I hate merge cells, but I understand why people use them, because there's a big thing right up here on the ribbon that encourages people to use merge cells. My number one complaint about this, yeah, I know it makes it difficult to sort and paste, but I am always navigating by using Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow. And when I press Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow from here, I'm going to touch cell A1 and watch what happens. I'm doing it in slow motion. As soon as I touch A1, my selection becomes three columns wide instead of one. All right, but what I'm doing is Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow, and now I've selected the whole range, and all I wanted to do was just bold the phrase column, all right? And I was in Huntsville, Alabama doing a seminar and just saying, well, you know, now there's nothing I can do. I press the down arrow and it's not getting narrow again. It becomes like a permanent thing. And a guy in the audience named Steve says, well, wait a second. What do you mean it's a permanent thing? All you have to do, and he had me do it again. So Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow. He says, keep holding down Shift and click on phrase, or click on that cell. And sure enough, that gets us back in. Now, admittedly, the whole reason I was using Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow is that I didn't have to go touch the mouse. I mean, if I was going to touch the mouse, I'd just hold down Shift and click on that. Although, I guess if I had 1,000 rows, I wouldn't be able to see that. But there we are. And then, when I was testing Steve's trick, you know, so if we start from that cell, we can Shift-click any cell and change the range, which I, yeah, it might be cool. I'm not sure that I knew that, or at least I've never used this trick before. But it also made me think, well, wait, can I solve this with the arrow? So Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow, and I do Shift+Down Arrow like I usually do. This is the point where I get frustrated with Excel. But all I would have to do is, while I keep holding down Shift, is press left, left, and I'm back to the selection that I was looking for. All right, now, Merge and Center, I know that that is popular because it's right there, but we can get the exact same effect if we would go into the dialog launcher here, and under horizontal, choose center across selection, like that, click OK. Right, we get the exact same view, but we don't have that annoying thing of Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow selecting across. If I needed just to select up to phrase, Ctrl+Shift+Up Arrow, Shift+Down Arrow, and everything is good. All right, tips like these are the tips that are in my book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. Click that I on the top right hand corner. And the wrap up, merge cells are evil. And my one particular rant is that the selected range gets larger when you touch a merge cell, and I can never make the selection narrower again. But there's two easy ways. Steve from Huntsville, keep holding down the Shift key, click in the cell just below the merge cell, or keep holding down the Shift key and press down arrow, left, left, to go back. It's not horrible. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, just an addenda. Now, this all assumes that the merge cell is at the top. If the merge cell's in the middle, there is nothing you're going to be able to do to get that thing back down to a single cell. I mean, you can shift click here, but there's, if you need to select the whole thing, never going to work. Center cross selection is the only way to go there.